Yep.
2, 4, 6, 8. We've notified 9 people so far.
Yeah.
Odds of winning pretty good if we give you a call. The only way we can call you is if we know who you are. And the only way you know who you are is if when you hear these keywords, you enter them. Either by texting 474-FROG or you go to froggy981.com. Caitlin got a call this morning with the great news that she now is a finalist for the trip. Who's going to be next? We'll find out later in the show. When we come back in a minute, we'll tell you what's in the box. We'll get it going. Again, we are live on the cam and on your radio. We'll be back here in just a few moments.
You're waking up with Gary and Johanna. Live on Facebook, YouTube, and on the Nebraska Now app. Fills my cup,
tops me up. It's awesome.
Gary and Johanna on Froggy 98. Froggy is sending you to Vegas for Garth.
Marvelous.
Text the keyword into the Big Barbecue Company text line.
Marvelous.
402-474-3764.
Marvelous.
Listen for a Viva La Garth in Vegas keyword.
Marvelous.
Garth in Vegas with Froggy 98.
Hi, I'm Senator Bo Ballard. I was born and raised in Lancaster County.
Da 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 da. Do, 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 do. Come on, man. Oh. Why? Why is it choose to update right now?
Ronnie. We got Ronnie.
Lookie. Why would it do that?
Oh, wow.
Why is it updating right now? It's supposed to update at night.
It's probably a forced update because you just
It's not a forced update.
Off.
I say update. I was supposed to update at night. Damn it.
Okay, we got Ryan.
Ryan.
Ronnie.
Is that a guy or a girl?
I don't know.
Girl.
I don't know. And Kylie.
Kylie, I met. I'm going to say Ronnie's a boy.
The texting makes me think it's a boy.
Because he was aggressive?
Just like not a lot of punctuation. But who knows?
You guys going to come out to the barbecue tomorrow?
Yeah.
There's a fundraiser tomorrow. Bread Man contacted Johanna about being a judge. She's going to be a rib judge.
Ken Cater. I'm going to judge some ribs.
Ribs.
I just see you like... Take a little bit
No, I'm going to get in there.
No, you are not.
Yes,
you're not
I
a
am.
Get in there, girl. I've never seen you get in there, girl.
I'll get in there, girl. You don't know. Give me a couple beers before. I'll get in there. Give me one margarita.
I like when you make yourself laugh.
I make myself laugh all the time. I think I have really good jokes to myself. I'm really catering to my own audience. You know,
imagine if you didn't think you were funny. That'd be terrible.
I would just know then I wasn't a funny person.
I know, but if you thought, this is probably multiple personality landscape here.
Oh, do I have to
If you told a joke.
Okay.
And then you didn't, yourself didn't laugh. How disappointed would you be in yourself? Is that multiple personality?
I don't think if you don't think it's funny, you would never tell the joke. This is kind of a mind F, but think about it.
Yeah.
If it's not funny to you, why are you telling it? But here's the thing, though. Sometimes I say things and people think I'm trying to be funny, but I'm not. And they laugh. And then I have to, like, force myself to laugh because I'm like, oh, shoot, they thought that was
a
joke.
Well, you could tell that you could try to be funny for the audience. Like, you could have done the one margarita for Nick and I, but you yourself didn't think it was funny.
I thought it was funny.
I know you did. I know you did. It's good that it aligns, but...
Yeah, I get it. I get what you're saying.
This thing is not
going
to update during the show. I guarantee it. This is going to be this all freaking morning.
Katrina, it's at Kincaider.
Let's go to Facebook, I guess. I feel like this chair is dirty I'm sitting in.
It's my chair.
I know it is. It feels itchy on my back, but maybe it's my shirt, but...
The back is, like, not a dirty material. It's, like, plastic. This one grosses me out. Look at this one.
Yeah.
This one is, like, I don't know.
When and where, eh, Jose?
Give me one margarita.
I'll put it in my.
No, I'm going to open my. Give me two margaritas.
Yeah, I don't. Actually, is there. I give you some. Brad, is, are there two Kincaiders?
Margaritas, I'm going to put it.
Johanna?
What?
What Kincaider?
Haymarket.
Yeah, downtown one.
And it's free to get in, but if you want a plate of food, it's $20 and you get a pulled pork sandwich, ribs, chips, and water,
that's
I believe.
That's a good deal.
And all the proceeds. All the proceeds, I believe. I need to go back and read the email better.
So you made yourself laugh on that one, yeah?
Yeah, I did.
That was an internal joke. That was a joke just for you.
Why are we just realizing this? That this is me.
I don't know.
What's that song? Oh, that's from Greatest Showman. My kids.
What time? 2 o'clock. Joe's gonna. I think. I don't know.
I think
actually.
You can. Just gosh darn it! Let me look at this dang thing.
What's up, Kyle? Man.
To get in the gate, it's free. It is a $20 donation to get a pulled pork sandwich, 3 ribs, bag of chips, and a bottle of water. Food will be available shortly after 2 p.m. until 8. All proceeds will go to buying a motorcycle for a deserving veteran who earned a Purple Heart during combat. And there's 3 singers coming in for entertainment. I will be there, a judge. Oh, it says judges. I will not be there. At 1:45... And then, oh, he said, that's it.
What?
That was the end.
Oh, that's how you ended it?
Just. Good price, I think. Yeah, Brad.
I think the whole gang may be down there. I don't know if Nick's going to make it or not, but Corey, I think, is going to go down there, too.
Brad.
Nick be hungover.
Nick. Nick said he's going to stop by, and he's getting wild because of UFC Day.
That's tonight. I thought UFC
2024
Day.
UFC Day.
Oh, tomorrow? Oh, it is.
Yeah, man. What are you doing for UFC? I
I remember those days. Kager days. I had a friend. He used to have keg parties. And then about 11 o'clock, he'd take everybody's money. 11 o'clock, he would just yell, get the F out. So he'd kick everybody out before that keg was empty. And then he'd start bottling it with empty milk jugs.
Oh, my gosh.
Put it in the fridge. Yeah.
My 30th yeah. that you left early for, I didn't want to waste any of the beer from the keg, so we all did.
I didn't get any FaceTime. Joe time. FaceTime. Hardly.
Yeah, you did. You
not much.
Whatever. That was on you. You were, you
I was
guys
stuck
were,
over there with Kyle.
You guys were all stuck in that corner because you chose to be. You were like really non-social.
I didn't know anybody.
So? It's your job to mingle with people you don't know.
Not off air. No, it's not.
You could have made an effort and came and talked to me, but you didn't.
I did.
I was just so shocked at the whole thing.
No, you were not.
Yes, I was.
I thought you said you knew it was coming.
No, I didn't. I was hoping something was happening because so far, Dane's only... He should have... What he should have done is made me another party.
Don't do what he should have done. Well, no what, man wants to know what I should have done.
No, I think so. I'm saying because then I would have been more... This is what happened. I was like, no, he's got to be... There's got to be a surprise because why am I only doing... The only thing we were doing for my birthday was going out with my cousins.
For
and 30th. I was like,
that's not hot.
No, but then I also was like trying not to make a big deal about it because it was my 30th and I was embarrassed.
Yeah.
And then I really thought it was, I really thought where he took me was going to be the pre to my party.
Yeah.
And then it turned out to be my party.
It was a good party.
A Rolodex of memories. What do you mean?
Remember when your hair got caught on fire? When you blowing out the candles?
My hair got up. Oh, yeah, it did. I forgot about
Good deal.
That. I did totally forget about that.
I know you totally did forget about it.
Did it happen in the moment?
Yeah.
Did I know it happened, or did I find out it happened later?
No, you knew because they had to blow it out.
Oh. Bum, 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 bum.
Need to update these beds more often. It just
They're
makes,
cool.
It makes it feel better,
it
you
feels
know?
Feels better. Oh, I thought you were getting...
Go ahead and put them on. It's time anyway.
You want to fight?
On the Nebraska Now app.
Vibes are high right now.
Gary and Johanna.
I love what they're playing.
On Froggy 98.
Give us fingers. Okay. What's in the box? We can't tell you yet. We're gonna in a sec. Got to make sure all the guests are at the radio station. Then we will bring them in one at a time. They stick their hands inside this nasty thing. Try to figure out what it is. Fastest one, Johanna, what do they get?
They get, I don't like that you asked me to, okay, I know this one. It's party pit passes to Walker Hayes and a stay at the hotel. Known by some as Hurrah's. Harrah's.
Johanna and I yesterday were talking on the phone, trying to, you know, we were finalizing today's What's in the Box. And she did, this is not a joke.
It's not a joke. It's what's in my head. I can't get
she
it
She said
out.
Harrah's yesterday on the phone with me. I said, Harrah's. It's Harrah's Casino.
I don't know if you don't get it. Like, this is such a quality my mom had, too. So I don't think it's going to go away from me. I get something, a word stuck in my head, and that's just what
you
it
can't
is.
Get it out of
that's
there.
What it is. Harrah's.
You're never going to get an endorsement deal from them. No.
Please don't give it to me. No. I don't want it.
Oh my God.
I won't be able to do it.
We only have two of the three guests here.
Are you kidding me?
Uh-uh.
I'm going to freak out.
Do we know? What do we got? Do we know who's missing? Do you know their names
I think
at all?
It's Ryan, but.
Yeah, we have Ronnie and Kylie.
All right. Is Ronnie a girl or a guy?
Guy.
It's a guy.
I'm gonna call this guy. Don't you
call
mess
him.
With me.
Call him. We can't tell anybody what's in the box till he comes.
He messaged me on Facebook and texted me. So
well, he's coming in.
He's coming in. He texted me or he messaged this morning at 6:58 and said, "I just woke up.
Oh my gosh.
I'll be there in 10 minutes." But it's definitely been 10 minutes.
Well, 10 minutes is not 10 minutes, really.
What do you mean?
There's no way he wakes up at 6:58 and he's going to be here at 7:08.
Well, he messaged at 6:58, so maybe he woke up before that. He said, just woke up, be there in 10 minutes. That was at 6:58. To me, that means you're out the door texting.
Sure. He's still not going to be here in 10 minutes. And well, he's not. It's been 20 already. We'll give him another minute. We'll take a break when we come back.
I had someone else, my friend.
Who's your friend?
Courtney.
Oh, my God. Why didn't you bring her in here?
I said, nah.
It's not necessary.
I don't know.
That's not necessary?
I told her to come in and play, and she goes, LOL, do you need someone? I go, technically, no. And I almost said to her, sometimes people don't show up. So we could have had some money in here.
I know. That's one of Johanna's
right
closest
now.
Friends.
I'm going to message her.
Yeah, message her. See what she's doing. When we come back, we'll tell you what's in the box, and we'll get it going, all right? You can watch us now. We're live on the cam, Froggy91 on Facebook, and we'll get into what's in the box here in about 3 minutes.
There are definitely people I would hang out with.
You're waking up with Gary and Johanna.
They wake me up.
Be part of the cam fam.
Every morning.
Froggy 98.
You don't know me.
Got old second sis on here.
She's not second sis. Janae?
Yeah.
Why do you say that? Probably because you never see her name come on. Why do you say
second
sis?
Yeah, Jenny.
Well, I guess she technically is second sis.
Jenny's
first sis.
Second sis. No, I'm not talking about the order that came out.
What are you talking about in order? Of what you know? Of who you know?
The people I see on. I see Jenny on here more than Janae. That's what that means. Until Janae starts participating more often, she's second sis.
Okay.
See, maybe I'll work her way up.
You think Billy watches our show?
No.
Exactly.
My brother?
Yeah.
He's on the radio.
He's not live in the morning.
Kind of.
No, he's not.
Yeah, he is.
I thought he only does his show in the afternoons and
no.
records it.
No.
Oh.
No. They're live, but they're like live.
Somewhere else.
No, don't try to guess. That's not true.
Yeah.
Like they would be right now, if we were my brother's show, he would be recording for this next break. They're just
he records
like right 10 minutes before it actually goes live.
What's the point of that? Just go live. Because
they like voice track is how they do it or something. It's not the same as us. They do it a different way.
Sounds.
Hey, Jenny, did you guys have fun last night? I saw you all at the Liba dinner.
Jenny, who can I run to? I'm finally seeing names again pop up. Now I can see people who are watching. For some reason, for a while there, I couldn't see them. Why don't you hook up morning shows one day? What?
His show's too big, guys.
Oh, hook up with his morning show. I'm just trying to be his friend. I don't know. I keep liking all his stuff on his page. I'm trying to get him to think I'm like this super fan.
Yeah.
You know? And then like notice me or something. Maybe he'll give me like a giveaway.
Maybe. His boy just broke his leg yesterday.
Oh, no way.
Yeah, and he's like in elementary school. Broke his tibia and fibia.
Oh, my God!
Playing soccer, somebody missed the ball and kicked him in the shin, I guess. What? Just a leg joke?
No, it wasn't, but he was laughing at me like it was. Oh.
Don't blame
me.
Wow,
I'm such a narcissist. I thought you were talking about me. Oh, my gosh. I'm obsessed with myself. Jeez. That's because he didn't kiss his sister. Oh. Did Billy ever have to kiss his sister?
No, but she didn't have a crush on him.
Oh, you were cuter.
I think I was. I mean.
When did you have the poopy teeth?
Huh?
When did you have the poopy teeth?
Pre then. I did not have poopy teeth then. I did not have poopy teeth then. I did, though. I don't know. How do you get a cavity right in the middle of the
teeth? I've seen it. I've seen it multiple times.
How?
I've seen it. I think it has. I've seen it multiple times. Like right here in the middle. It's common with kids, I think. Not common, but common with like dirty kids, maybe. Like.
Oh, I was dirty. We lived on a military base.
I mean, and the kids aren't dirty. It's just like it feels like unkept. But maybe not. Some kids just get cavities really bad naturally. I think it has to do with your bacteria in your mouth.
Some I don't know have that I brush. I think that I brush. My dad was like militant in a way.
But you still got it?
Yeah.
So see, maybe you just have the wrong cut, which makes sense because you got thrush as
an adult. I did.
As a very big adult, you have got thrush. And that it seems like to me you have messed up stuff.
Mouth stuff?
Mouth stuff. Mouth bacteria.
Not good.
Kristen, where are you going? You going to the beef, Sid? I need to get back there. I need to call my dad. I haven't talked to my dad in a long time. Sister Kissa.
Wow. Not next to me. Wow. Guys, we got to get this going. So if he's not here.
Lebanon. You know that's a geographical center of the United States?
That doesn't sound right.
Yeah, it is.
I didn't say it wasn't.
Oh, wait, is it Lebanon, Nebraska, or Lebanon, Kansas?
There's a Lebanon, Missouri, too.
Is there?
Yeah.
Wow. That's how Philo uses it. Wow.
That makes him not feel good about themselves.
Oh, it's terrible. I have a video of her saying it today. I was like, honey, it's your dad's birthday. And she goes, wow. Mouth tendencies, for sure. Drinking juice as kids contributes to a lot of cavities, I've heard.
I drink juice, probably. Mouth tendencies. Josh, get out of here.
That was a big chomp. I apologize.
I heard it.
I felt it.
I knew I felt it.
I'll just, you know.
I look haggard, guys. Sorry about it.
No, you don't. Why do you think you look haggard? Because you're wearing a hat?
No, it's my eyes. More my face. Because
you're doing this?
Yeah, probably.
What'd you say to me? Come out to play. Come on. Come on.
Oh, yeah,
because
you're like, put your hood up and you're like zipped it up.
I just wanted a little bit of a nap. Yesterday, get this. Yesterday, get this.
I'm trying.
Yep, I'm trying to get it as well.
Three?
As I was talking. Two only?
He's got 1 minute.
He's a liar to me. He lied to me. And I could have had my friend come. I'm angry. No, I'm not. It'll be okay.
We can't add him to the mix.
No. Unless this guy is here. What if I'm messaging the wrong person?
Oh, what if you are?
Wait a second.
Well, the one we're missing is...
Well, here. I'll
Ryan.
Text this.
We're missing Ryan. Who are you... No. Yeah, we're missing Ryan. Do you have his name?
Did one of these phones go off? I just texted him.
No.
This
Wait
guy.
A minute. Maybe it did.
I can still make it. Keisha,
Johanna.
Come in.
Maybe it did.
It did go off?
Something happened.
Oh, gosh.
Just
Keisha,
look at
come
the
in.
Name. Johanna.
Keisha, come in. Ronnie then didn't come in. Where's Ronnie?
Ronnie's here. He said Ronnie and Kylie are here.
Oh, okay, so it's Ryan.
Ryan. Oh, my God, Almighty, I just said that. We got to move on anyway. We don't have time.
Keisha, come. Okay. Well,
we got time for Keisha, come. We got to go.
Okay.
Ryan, where are you? Listener Ryan, he texts us. It's 6:58. He's supposed to be. He was scheduled to come on the show this morning to be a part of What's in the Box. 6:58. He says, guys, just woke up. I'll be there in 10 minutes. It's now 7:35. He ain't here yet. Did you text him?
Yeah, I did. I texted. I said, are you here? And because I wanted to see if one of these phones went off because I think there's. Are we sure it's Ronnie and Kylie are here?
I think.
Keisha's on the cam said, I won't listen, promise, headed. I think I believe her.
God, I know, but what happens if she... This is a really good prize. Party pit passes to Walker Hayes and a night stay at Harris Casino, and you're going to trust her?
I mean, I don't know what your beliefs are, but if you're lying, you're going to go to hell.
I think that stopped anybody. Is he here?
Oh, my
Ryan
gosh! Keisha, stay home.
Stay home, Keisha. We don't need you now. Thank you, though. Okay.
That was stressful. Whoa.
Well,
whoa.
You know what that means is we're gonna bring him in first.
Why?
Well, I got to yell at him, I think.
Okay, yeah, I agree. Let's go. Yeah.
That's like Radio 101. Listeners
right
are always
now.
Right. No, they're not. Sometimes they screw up, and they need to be told.
I don't have time for these heart attacks so early in the morning.
Trying to wreck a show. I think we have his phone, so we're going to tell you what's in the box now.
Oh, my gosh.
They're party pit passes. So the tie-in is to pit, armpit. Johanna wanted me to get my arm hairs in there.
I did. I wanted you to trim them up.
I'm thinning.
Who cares?
It's really not good what's happening under there.
Question though, why do you care? Why don't you just shave
There's
them
not
off?
Enough.
Who
There's
cares?
Not enough.
There's enough to touch. Is there not?
What I didn't know is the older that you get, not only does your hair thin on top, it thins
everywhere.
Under your arms. I don't know down there.
And on your legs.
There, down there. Yeah, on my legs, I don't have any hair.
I
anymore.
Know. So it all consolidates. Oh, gross.
Yeah, Nick.
Ryan is ready.
Okay, give us a minute
give
here.
Give us a minute.
I don't know. Are we ready? Do we have anything else to say about hair?
Well, we haven't
we didn't
told
tell
anybody
what
what's in the box. We are a mess today.
It's Ryan's fault. We're doing great.
It is Ryan's fault. We're blaming him.
What we have this morning is deodorant for the pits.
For the pit passes.
Right. We took it out of... We wound and wound and wound and wound and wound, and wound until it came popped all the way out of the container. So it's just a stick. Of deodorant that's in the box.
Yeah, the innards.
Right. So that is what we're, that's the answer that we're looking for. Let's go ahead and get him. We're going to bring in Ryan. And then we're going to see what his time is. The fastest time is going to win tickets. There he is. He has got the goggles on. Bring him over to the microphone. Get his headphones on. And then we'll get got a Jimmy John's t-shirt
And a hat. I think he works at Jimmy John's.
Freaky fast, I say not. He's supposed to be here early. Where you been, Ryan? Are you freaky fast? You work at Jimmy John's?
Yeah.
I mean, he did wake up really late.
Were you up late? What were you doing last night? This is so funny. If you're on the cam, you can see him. He can't even find the microphone. That's a microphone. It should hold there. Can you pull your head?
What's on the stand?
The microphone.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, the microphone is on a stand. You can't see because you're blindfolded. What happened, bud? Why'd you oversleep?
I was just up late.
What were you doing?
Staying on Facebook.
Staying on Facebook. That'll get you.
I like the honesty, though.
Yeah.
You know?
Were you, like, talking to girls or something? Are you married? What's your deal?
No, I was just looking around.
Were you finding anything good?
No.
That's hard sometimes to put down. You're a Facebook guy, though? No, like, TikTok or Instagram or nothing like that?
No.
Facebook all the way. Man, don't ever get on TikTok. I think it's addicting.
All right. Are you ready to play the game? Oh, Johanna, do you want to say...
As ready as I will be.
Do you want to say anything to him about being late? You want to reprimand him?
Hey, I'm too old for this, all right? I need you. If you tell me you're going to be here at 7 a.m., you get here.
I am so sorry. I even told
Never mind.
I was sorry that I was late.
No,
it's okay.
You are so sweet. I don't care. You can be late all the time.
Yeah,
don't you worry about it.
Whatever. We don't care. It's just a loosey-goosey show. You know what I mean?
I'm never fashionably late, so.
Yeah. What'd he say?
He's never fashionably late. This is like unfashionably late.
Ryan, do you know how to play the game? Have you heard it on the radio or have you seen it before?
Yes, I have.
All right, there's an item in the box. There's two holes on each side. When you hear a buzzer, your hands are going to go in. If you have the fastest time, party time, okay? First thing you're going to do is probably get back on Facebook and post that I won.
Yes.
All right? If you win, we're talking about party pit passes for Walker Hayes and a night stay at Harrah's Casino.
And do we get any money for the slots and stuff or no?
Do you get any money for the slots?
Oh, money for the slots.
I give you $5.
All right.
Woo!
Okay. Yeah.
Got Gary Greenwood putting up some cash. Dang.
Will you give him $5?
I don't believe in gambling.
You got to win first.
I don't need safety gloves or nothing, do I?
Well.
No, do you want them?
No.
Yeah.
Nick threw them away, so we don't even have them anymore.
Yeah, we don't. Okay, buddy. It's time to play, Ryan, if you're ready.
All right.
Nick, are you ready with the timer? Okay, wait until the buzzer. You hear the buzzer, then hands go inside. Ryan. It is time to play What's in a Box. Good luck to you. Out.
No.
Still have no idea, even though the game is over, the pressure's off?
Some kind of soap.
That's very close. It feels like a bar of soap, doesn't it?
It does.
Yeah. It is actually, you know, you'll appreciate the tie-in when we tell
deodorant.
You. It's deodorant. For the pits, for the armpits, because they're giving away pit passes.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah.
The bottom kind of like threw me off a little bit.
That's because we had to unwind it all the way to get it out. So that's the very bottom of the deodorant. It's got a little notch on it or something, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well.
Can I take my glasses off?
If you want. You want to see us?
You're so nice. He's so sweet.
Yeah. How you doing, buddy?
I'm good.
There you are.
Hey, there he is.
Well, buddy, you got a time of zero, which is not good. But nobody else is gone yet. So all we can hope for now is that they can't figure it out either. And if that's the case, then it'll be just kind of, we'll figure it out, you know, who's going to win. But we'll send you back into the green room, and then don't tell anybody what it is. Maybe go wash your hands, too, so they can't smell it on your hands.
All right.
All right, Ryan, thanks, man.
Thank you.
When we come back, our only woman in today's competition is Kylie, and she'll be joining the show for What's in the Box when we come back.
Breakfast, my coffee in the morning out on the patio.
They go to work.
Gary and Johanna.
I just listen in, and I start cracking up.
Morning, 6 to 10.
Nick, said, no sound. What?
I said, maybe go wash your hands. He goes, oh, okay. I see him. He just walks directly to the green room. Oh, well, that's fair.
He rang the doorbell and came sprinting in. I was like, all right, go to the green room. And then I walked in there and was like,
all right,
let's go.
Oh, my God.
He was so sweet.
So sweet.
Guys, chill. The Zoom died. Oh, I gotta pee.
Why you gotta pee already?
Because I drank a whole drink.
You drank a whole drink.
This stuff. Will you drink one if I bring you in one?
I used to drink that kind of stuff. I used to make it every morning. I'm fresh.
Why are you saying it's so sassy?
Well, you act like it's a little insulting. You don't think I've ever had a green drink before.
Yeah, I kind of don't think you have.
I have, but not yours.
I used to drink it every morning, fresh. Good thing they don't. Corey, that's really funny.
Yeah.
It's strong on me now.
I don't think anyone is going to guess it, too. It's too close to a bar of soap.
I was worried about that.
Well, I didn't hear those concerns yesterday.
Yes, huh? That was one of the concerns, the main and only concern I gave you.
Well, we better start figuring out a tiebreaker.
Go ahead.
Johanna May.
What? Gary Todd.
Why you got attitude?
Because you giving me attitude first.
I got
first.
No attitude to get you.
What?
I got no attitude to get you.
David, I did not go to Bucky's. A listener sent this to me. Gosh darn it. I meant to say their names. What are their names? It's mother, daughter, Sheila. And what's her daughter's name? I feel so terrible I can't remember her daughter's name. They live in Texas, and they sent us Bucky's gear. And that it's been a while ago, maybe a few years ago. I've never personally been to a Bucky's. I mean, you almost accepted caulk gun last week, so maybe soap is close.
Well, I was just thinking about that. It is soap for the underarm, kind of.
Guys, we can't go back and listen because the audio wasn't working. It doesn't count.
Soap doesn't?
Even if it does count, no, we didn't say it. No, soap doesn't
count. We don't know
when
he said
it. Soap doesn't count. Soap does not count regardless. It's not, that's, no.
I think
David, life-changing? Everybody's saying this news about the Bachelor getting divorced after 3 months, but I heard already that they were
what
living
what Bachelor? Oh, you're talking about
the Goldenrod.
The Gold, are they living separate? They're already divorced. The Goldenrod.
I knew it was wrong as it came out.
Froggy 98.
What's in the box? First guess was Ryan. Ryan could not figure it out. He got a time of zero. Now we got two left, Kylie and Ronnie. If they can figure it out, and now we're a little concerned that everybody's going to say soap. That it's soap that's in there, and it's not. It's deodorant. That's what's in the box this morning. It's, you know, deodorant for the armpits, and we're giving away party pit passes, so that's the clever tie-in that we thought we had. And we took it. We took the deodorant, and we, like, unwound it, or I guess wound it, or what? No.
I mean, I guess it's like wound it up. But, none of that sounds right.
No.
We took it out. The innards is out.
Yeah, that's a better way to say it.
But this is why we did that, is because we thought it would be way too easy to just put it, the whole thing. But you know what we could have done? Maybe not, but left it in and then screwed it all the way up.
I know, but I still think that they would have said deodorant fast.
I still think they would have gotten it too soon, but now it's almost like this might be too hard. But we'll see, whatever.
We got two left. Kylie is next. So we're getting set up in here. We're having some things we're trying to fix in here, but going to get Kylie. I think we may need a woman's brain on this one.
You think so?
I think she's going to bring it home. Yep.
I like it. I like the way you think. Girls for the win. Did we figure out if Ronnie is a girl or a boy?
Boy.
It is a
when
boy.
Ryan, when he smelt it, when Tom smells fingers, he said, ew.
And it was like a genuine ew, too.
Yeah.
But you know what? I think he was, maybe, you know how you can psych your brain out?
The flavor, the scent is musk.
Musk?
But that name in itself is not good. Yeah, okay. Let's go ahead and bring
him
in.
Come on.
Right, here she comes. Oh, Kylie.
Oh my gosh, that's so weird. I almost wore that exact same shirt today. Yeah, and then I didn't. Dang it, I should have wore it.
Kylie was at the radio station super early this morning. So you're gonna put those headphones on, Kylie, and then step up to the microphone. I know you can't see it because you're blindfolded. All of our guests are blindfolded. We like to remove a sense.
Get her close. Don't be too scared. There you go. A little closer.
Good morning. Can you hear us in your headphones?
There you go.
Yes.
Hi, how are you?
A little nervous.
Are you?
Yep.
What are you nervous about?
I don't know.
Have you ever been on the radio?
Yeah, I think, like...
We had you on before?
Yeah. I don't know how long ago, though.
Was it for this?
No.
Was it for the dating show?
No, the Dare, I think.
Oh, we had you on. Did we paint or pass?
Yes, that's what
you did. Paint or pass?
Yep. Oh my goodness, she's a tough one.
What did we do to you?
Wet willy, spanking, and the
clamps.
Yeah.
Oh, we clamped her.
She had the nipple clamps.
We clamped her.
You came back for more, huh?
Yes.
Okay. Something in there you got to figure it out fastest time.
Okay.
If you do, you're going to go see Walker Hayes.
Yes.
Before they go on sale. We have party pit passes and we have a night stay at Harris Casino. Do you have any questions?
No, I don't think so.
You've seen the game before?
Not really. Okay. I just heard it here and there.
Okay. Well, let's quickly explain it. You're going to hear a countdown, 3, 2, 1, and a buzzer. When that goes off, you're going to put your hands in the box, all right? There's holes on each side of it. So stick your hands inside and then tell us what you are feeling.
Okay.
And if it's the fastest time, you win. It really is that simple.
No. Okay.
Okay?
I'm really bad at these games, but...
I think you'll be all right. My pick was you to win.
Okay. Yeah, it was. He really thinks you're going to bring this one home. His exact words.
Okay. Are you ready to play?
Yeah.
By the way, the guys on the camera wanting to know if you're single.
I'm... Me?
Yeah.
Oh, no, I'm taken.
She taken, guys. Sorry.
Took her a while to say that, though.
Oh, no. I was like, I'm nervous with this game.
That's okay. All right. Here we go. It's time to play Kylie What's in a Box. Good luck to you. Okay.
The game begins in 3, 2, 1.
Get him inside and start feeling. What is that? Oh, she has a one hand
soap.
One hand job on her.
Bar soap.
No. Two hands now.
I'm scared. I don't know.
Two hand job.
Better?
Now.
Is that better? No.
Deodorant.
Time.
Oh. Okay.
Put nice job. Okay. It's used. Yes.
Oh my gosh.
It's used.
Who's?
We don't know. We found it in the alley.
Oh my god.
We found it out in the alley. There were some pubes on it. We pulled off.
Pubes.
Underarm ones.
Why are there pubes?
Underarm.
You don't call those pubes.
Yeah, you do.
Yes,
you do. Underarm hair.
I've never called my armpit hair pubes.
Well, what's
no,
the
you
difference?
Never. No. No pubes. I'll tell you this, though. It does help with razor burn on your bikini line.
Oh, does it?
Antiperspirant does. Yeah, if you put it on your bikini line, if you shave, it seriously, yeah, helps with razor burn.
Yeah, no, I've never tried that.
Yeah, I have a whole stick just for that area.
Can you, just curious, can you smell your fingers and tell us what scent it is?
What?
Yeah. Did you smell them? Smell your fingers.
I don't want to. No. Is this part of the game?
For extra credit, if there's a tiebreaker, this would be the tiebreaker.
Just guess what? Old Spice.
No. Oh. Smell your fingers.
What? Spring. The spring?
What, Johanna?
I was seeing what right brand
there.
It was.
It's right there.
Oh, I see.
Is it green?
No, it's not.
Oh, great. Mm-mm.
All right.
No.
You sure you don't want it? You don't want it for this
whiff?
Tiebreaker?
Nope. I don't know whose armpits these
What's
are.
What's her time? What do you say, Johanna? Can you hear him?
19 seconds.
All right.
Nice job.
Kylie, good job. We're going to put you back into the green room, okay? And then we'll let you know if you're the winner after our final guest comes in next. All right?
All right.
It is What's in a Box for Party Pit Passes for Walker Hayes and a night stay at Harris Casino. Our last guest is Ronnie. He joins the show next.
Gary and Johanna, live on Facebook, YouTube, and...
All right. Good job.
Okay. Nice work. Do you want to wash your hands?
It was brand new deodorant.
Oh, it was?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, snailed. I told you.
What kind of job was it, Gary? It's a one-hand job, guys.
Michaela, she texted me like an hour ago saying how nervous she was. It's really sweet.
Oh, that's sweet. Sister, kiss the time to get it on. You know what song I sang to my kids yesterday that I thought
Oh, you're right, because a pubic bone. That's yeah. Why it's pubic hair, pubes.
It's all the same, isn't it? That would mean the hair on your head is also pubes.
No, because I think private. I think private hair means private pubes.
Private pubes? You got private and public pubes?
that's funny.
Sister kiss the top. You know, oh, I was going to tell you the song I was singing to my kids yesterday.
Yeah.
We listened to it. And Dane didn't know what song it was.
Really?
Yes, hold on. Let me sing it to you.
Sing it to me.
Oh, I got to think of it now. Oh, where had the baby be?
The Lord took her away from me. She gone to heaven, so I gotta
not the
be
right
good.
Key right there. You're wrong there. But
so I can see my baby when I leave
this world. Pearl Jam.
No, Becky. Aunt Becky has sung that song all the time.
Really? It was like my favorite song when I was a kid. I loved it. I thought it was such a beautiful, sad story. Didn't she die in a car
accident? I don't stand to poop, Linda.
What?
I don't stand to poop.
Remember,
that's
this
a false
is coming
narrative.
From a man that stands. Let's spread it, guys. Let's spread it. He stands.
Private chest pubes.
Wait, what?
Chest pubes. Private chest pubes.
I'm seriously going to pee my pants today for real. I have to pee for that. I'm not crying. I'm peeing now. Now I pee. Leave me alone. What's Last Kiss, Sean? Is Willie's? What? Is that a song?
Willie's.
Just curious.
Gone to heaven, so I gotta be good.
So I can see my baby when I leave this world. Where can my baby be? The girl took her away from me.
I don't know Pearl Jam sang that.
I'm pretty sure, right?
I mean, I don't know where it originally came from. Aunt Becky used to sing that back in the 80s.
thought it was Pearl Jam, but I think it was, I think, no. I think there was an older version, and Pearl Jam made it popular. Mm. How much time, Gear Bear?
10 seconds before we start, and then give us probably 45 seconds, so about a minute.
Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I., and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Gary and Johanna in the morning are live on YouTube. Just search Frog Mornings, Froggy 98.
What's in the box? We have three guests in to try to figure it out. We have party pit passes for Walker Hayes in a night stay at Harris Casino. So we're tying it into pit. We have deodorant, you know, for your armpits. Kylie figured it out in 19 seconds. We did lie to her and tell her it was deodorant we found in the alleyway. That's why she wouldn't smell it. We tried to get her to let us know what scent it was. And if she did that, that would be the tiebreaker, but she didn't do it. So our final guest this morning is Ronnie. Let's go ahead and welcome Ronnie. Let's bring him in, Nick. Let's see if he can beat the fastest time. Again, the winner is going to be going to Walker Hayes. Those tickets go on sale at 10 o'clock this morning. Bring him in.
Bring him in.
It's got to be a better system. I'm yelling through the door.
Yep. I know.
Let's go ahead and bring him in.
We need, like, walkie-talkies.
That's really a good one.
Yeah.
I like that.
Oh, let's get walkie-talkies. You can buy them for, like, 10 bucks on Amazon.
Okay.
Ronnie looks like he got some swag, don't he?
Oh, he got the backward hat.
And the way he kind of, like, moves his body. You see how he walks? He walks
I am scared right now.
Are you scared? They survived. The two before you survived.
Yeah, but I got trust issues.
You do?
Oh, yeah.
And you chose to play this game from a girl.
Terrible. Hey, exes, man.
You get cheated on?
Couple times.
Oh, that's
more than once?
Hey, you gotta make sure it's good, right?
Oh, yeah, I guess.
I don't know what that means, but sure.
I think he's given permission to cheat. Test him out. Hey, see which one's good.
Sometimes. I'm kidding. I do not endorse.
Okay.
Good.
All right. Listen, you're in here to win some party pit passes. Looks like you would tear it up in a pit.
Yeah.
A couple times. And then you get to stay at Harris Casino because we got a night stay at Harris.
Then
same night.
Waste all my money.
That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
All you got to do, bud, is figure out what's in the box faster than the other two. We can't tell you if they figured it out, and we can't tell you if they did what times they have. We'll let you know after you.
Okay.
After you play.
Sound like he's like, we'll never tell.
We will in the end. Do you know how to play the game? Have you ever seen or heard it on the radio?
Yeah.
All right. So just quickly for maybe somebody new that's listening, you're going to hear a countdown, then a buzzer. When you hear the buzzer, that's when we're going to start the time, and that's when your hands will go in. There's holes on each side of the box. And then as soon as you figure it out, just start yelling out what you think it may be. Time will stop if it's the fastest, and you win. Real easy.
All right.
Are you ready to play? Do you have any questions?
No, I'm good.
All right, Ronnie. Go ahead and get your hands closer to the holes. We're going to save you a little time. Don't get them in yet. It's time to play. It's time to play What's in the Box. Good luck to you, bud.
The game begins in 3, 2, 1.
In they go, Ronnie. Oh, he's got them both hands on.
Is that deodorant?
Oh.
Time.
Is that it? Do I keep going?
Smell your fingers.
Oh. What?
Smell your fingers.
Yeah, it's deodorant.
Oh, my God.
Or soap? Soap?
No, it's deodorant. How did you do that?
How did you do that?
I wear deodorant? I don't know.
He seems very clean. You know what I mean?
I try. I bathe. You know, I'm a toddler bag.
What's the smell? What's the scent? Smell your fingers.
Like Irish Spring?
Oh, everybody thinks it's Irish Spring. No.
Well, that was unbelievable. Is the radio on out there?
No.
What's the time? Like, that was unreal. 4 seconds? Four seconds was the time.
I can also run 40 yards in that time. You know?
Oh, that one I don't believe.
That's a lie. I'm not going
to
lie. That's a lie.
Okay. Well, listen, I think that we can. I don't even know that we need to bring the other guests in to tell them the news.
That was the craziest thing.
What
does high score mean? Did I break it?
High score, we had the first guy who was late. When he smelt it, first of all, he said, ooh, he didn't like the smell of deodorant.
Checks out.
He did not figure it out.
How?
Yeah, he didn't figure it out. The second person that came in.
I'm not going to lie. I think it's because I felt like the little spinny thing on the bottom.
Oh. And that's what was throwing people off.
Right.
They were going for soap, and then they couldn't get it out of their head that it wasn't soap. Mm. Yeah.
And soap was his second guess. So.
Right, yeah.
Well, yeah, because y'all went quiet. I didn't know if I was right or wrong.
We were shocked. You can't see our face. I know. Kylie got it in 19 seconds, and you got it in 4 seconds, so you are the winner. Congratulations.
Woo!
Yeah.
Nice work.
You're the winner. Yeah, you can take them off. You're going to go see Walker Hayes. Before tickets go on sale, so we have tickets for you, party pit passes, and we've got the hotel stay for you, too.
Sick.
And we have a stick of deodorant if you want it.
I'm so good. I got
All right, congratulations. We have to let the other guests know that they didn't win, but you are the winner, Ronnie. We'll hook you up with that prize pack. We appreciate you coming in.
Appreciate you.
We'll do What's in the Box again next Friday. If you ever want to play, let us know.
Gary and Johanna, live on Facebook, YouTube, and on the Nebraska Now app.
I think part of the surprise is just because they struggled with it so much, we just assumed that it was not going to.
They told me it was going to bite me.
Like, they told you that? They're trying to they're messing with you?
Okay, just the highlighted parts.
Okay.
Yep.
So looking full
name
or what? Yeah. Oh, man. Ronnie is a bro. Love it.
Sylvania, it does. So not on, it probably would cover garlic smell. You, come on, bud. Are you going to the bathroom? Because I need to go.
No, I'm
going to
go tell these guys they didn't win.
Come here.
Oh, my goodness. I can't even type my email.
Can't type your email?
You know what I'm at.
That'll be so fun, though. Oh, Party pit passes, baby. Let's go. No way. Is she single? I don't think she's single.
We'll find out.
To be honest with you, I'm pretty sure we just asked her and she said she wasn't single.
We got nothing, man. What? Okay, pause.
No.
Real quick.
Gotta win.
Why do I need to put my social security number?
Probably because it's like worth that much money and
I'm in for
probably for the hotel room. We usually don't ask that, so I'm guessing it's only the only reason why.
What Jimmy John's you work at? See you later.
Bye.
Have a nice weekend.
Bye.
Yeah. How long have you been there?
6 months.
Oh, I didn't realize that. Yeah. Like that on the bottom.
Yeah.
Oh, y'all popped the thing.
You're a manager?
We took it all the way out.
How did I guess that?
Yeah.
I thought this was a spinny thing. I'm not going to lie.
I'm going to stop over when you get off work. Yeah. Get you a sandwich.
Sweet. I'll make my way over there.
All right.
I love Jimmy John.
Yeah.
I wasn't talking about you.
He's the manager. Yeah, he's talking about you.
Oh, you're not talking about me?
I'm just kidding.
Guess who goes to the party?
Yeah.
Let me just see. Digital tickets host day to be determined.
Good job.
They'll reach out to you. So as long
we'll see you, man.
See
you, buddy.
Rodney, is it Colson?
Yeah.
2015.
Yeah, cause my real name is Rodney, but I go by Ronnie.
Okay. Because the tickets will come to you on your email.
And it won't be for
and
a while.
Tell you
it'll be like the week of the show.
It'll be like the week of the show.
Okay.
Okay,
all right,
okay cool.
Good.
Thank you. Yeah.
That's all we need, man. All right, congrats.
So
have a nice weekend. Nice to meet you.
You
got your phone?
No.
Is that yours right there?
Yeah,
yeah, there you go. All right, bud.
Thank you.
See you, man.
Bye.
Talking about holes in one hand jobs. Interesting show this morning. Mine was slip of tongue or whatever. Johanna was trying to get laughs. I didn't say mine. Oh, hey, Jen. Good morning. Do you know him, Christina? Or is he just a bro? He redid. He gone to heaven, so I gotta be good. Oh, man. Takes it out of you. Did that work better, the iPad, or no?
Yeah, it would have if it would have stayed charged.
Oh, really?
It's so old that
yeah.
I, like, if it's not at 100%,
yeah,
like when I hop on like a FaceTime or a Zoom like that, it just drains it so fast.
That fast?
Yeah, that the charger doesn't even keep up with it.
Wow.
It'll drain it until it dies while it's on the charger.
Wow.
Yeah, it's like, I don't even know how old it is. It's gotta be, it's like an iPad 8, and I think they're on like 16 or 17 for the iPads or something crazy.
Hmm.
But once I threw my laptop in there, it worked
better.
It
was fine.
Yeah.
Was it degree invisible solid? It's, no. Johanna should like this. It's aluminum free. I didn't know that. It's this kind.
Oh my gosh, it smells so like deodorant right now.
Musk deodorant. See, but there's no antiperspirant because there's no aluminum in it.
I don't, why do you care if you actually sweat? I care about the smell.
Guys care about sweat.
Why?
They just do. I care about both, though. I want both.
I want both.
K is for Kansas, guys.
Kansas.
It's Kansas basketball.
Kansas basketball. Rock Chuck Jayhawks.
Do you actually care about the sweat?
Yeah.
Oh.
You don't sweat then. I don't either, but my boys, they sweat like this. Like, it's like, and when you're single and you're trying to talk to girls and you have this big sweat ring around your armpits, it's no fun.
I totally get that. I get that now.
I think I only use deodorant. I don't use, like, an antiperspirant.
Yeah, you don't sweat deodorant. Then. You just naturally don't sweat much.
I love sweating, though. Like, I don't like smelling, but I like
Go ahead,
sweating.
Tell the story. Go ahead and tell the story. I know what you're leading into.
I'm not going to say that. About the garlic?
No.
What? Sorry.
Your husband likes your stink.
I wasn't going to say that. I really wasn't.
That's how you always go.
He does like my smell. Thanks for bringing that up. Sometimes I forget. Yeah, he does. He likes my natural scent. My natural pheromones. Actually, I feel like he's lying to me.
I don't. I don't think so. I think that he worships the ground that you walk on in every way.
I think so, too.
You could do no wrong. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, he's sweet. Except for he got sassy with me about the garden yesterday.
You didn't like it? Put him in his place?
Mm-mm.
We'll see you, Willie.
No, it worked. It made me feel, I said, okay, I understand it's important to you now. Now I feel like I need to do it with him.
Impens, what's that? I'm going to screenshot. Thompson T undershirts. Okay. You got a sweat problem too? Some guys just can't control it. You just start sweating.
You got a sweat problem too.
It's a curse. It's a man curse. Are there any women that?
Yes. I had a friend.
No way. Not like that.
I had a friend that had to get like clinically strong deodorant because
your girlfriend.
No, a girlfriend. Yeah, a girlfriend, but not nobody you know.
Oh.
Like when I was in high school.
Did she
I
tell
sweat
you
a lot. I feel like I sweat a lot.
You have no idea what sweat is.
Yes, I do. I know what garlic stinky sweat is.
I do too.
Okay. I don't even care. Who cares? You know what? I read all this stuff about how garlic is like anti-cancer.
It's a strong one. You know what
I mean? Yeah, but I know. But think about this, though. Would you rather smell like garlic or be dying?
Well, garlic, obviously. But that's not 100% sure that if you don't eat garlic, you're going to have cancer.
Some percent chance.
It's these witchcraft.
It's not witchcraft. It's from the earth. That's what we're supposed to... Our ancestors passed down. I don't know what I'm saying.
I don't either.
Gary. Oh, I already read that.
What?
I was going to read that. Thanks again for the opportunity. You're welcome, Ronnie. Have a blast. Ronnie. I hope you find a hottie. Oh, Ronnie, do you want to come on Why Am I So Single?
He's single?
Well, he was going to ask that girl. I spared him.
What girl?
He was going to ask the girl. He was going to take the girl that was here with him. He wanted to ask her, but she already told us she was dating someone.
Oh, my God. Get him on the show for next week. We're looking
for
a feature.
Ronnie, do you want to be a feature? Caitlin, I mean, there are other options than garlic or death.
She's very dramatic. Very dramatic.
Join the Cam Fam now. Head to facebook.com/froggy981.
Congrats again to Ronnie. He was our winner this morning with What's in the Box. He's going to Walker Hayes. Those tickets go until 10 o'clock this morning. And he's got the party pit passes and the hotel stay. We're trying to get him to be our single, our feature for next week's Why Am I Still Single? Are you messaging him right now?
Yes. I just replied to him on the cam and said, do it! Because he said, shoot. I don't know what that means.
I don't either.
Must be something the cool kids are saying.
Are you ready to call another finalist for Garth Brooks?
Yeah, let's go.
We're giving away a trip to see Garth in Las Vegas over 4th of July weekend. It's his residency at Caesar's Palace. You got to listen for these keywords. We got another one coming up here, by the way, when we're done talking. We'll hit a button and then you text it in, or you go online, or and go online and enter it. And you could be getting a call from us saying you're a finalist for this. There's not going to be a lot of people that are finalists, so your odds of winning are really good. And we haven't really got into this yet, but if you never end up getting a call from us saying, hey, congratulations, you're a finalist, you'll be invited to come out.
Yeah.
To Madsen's Bowling and Billiards on the 23rd. That's when we're giving this away for an opportunity to still win the trip, even if you never became a finalist. Okay? We'll have more details on that coming for you real soon. First, though, let's call this finalist, and this was a text person. Okay? And let them know that they're now closer to going to Garth Brooks in Las Vegas. Okay, 1 second there. I feel like doing this normal, by the way.
Why? Larry.
Just kind of, I'll do breathy, maybe.
Too breathy.
I'll do breathy, though, not
yeah,
Larry.
Like hot.
Okay.
Hello?
Hi.
You've got to be kidding me.
Oh, Jennifer.
Can't even play along with you right now.
You remember me?
Sounds like you are playing along. Oh, yeah, yeah.
What's terrible is now that is getting ladies excited when they know the news. It's not that they did anything wrong, they did everything right.
Oh, my God.
Jennifer, congratulations. You were a finalist to go see Garth Brooks in Las Vegas.
I'm one step closer, baby.
That's what we're talking about.
So, oh, I want her to win.
We got you through text yesterday. So you heard one of the keywords yesterday and you texted in. How many times did you do that yesterday?
Oh, I don't even know. I know I've got 76 entries online because it counts for me.
Wow.
Wow.
But I probably have just as many texts because every time I hear online or hear it, I do online and text. So
wow.
Paid off.
I want this.
It paid off, Jennifer. You're in now.
All right.
You don't have to. We want you to keep listening that often, but you don't have to enter any more because we're going to have you come out to the grand finale where you could be winning that trip to Garth in Las Vegas.
Ah!
Yeah!
Woo!
Congratulations!
Thank you.
You're welcome. Hang on 1 second, and we got another Garth keyword for you right now.
Gary and Johanna. And I'm next to you. Morning 6 to 10.
As soon as I wake up, they wake me up.
And I'm next to you. Gary and Johanna in the morning on Froggy 98. Froggy is sending you to Vegas for Garth.
Pelican.
Text the keyword into the Big Barbecue Company text line.
Pelican.
402-474-3764.
Pelican.
Listen for a Viva La Garth in Vegas keyword.
Pelican.
Garth in Vegas with Froggy.
Okay, we just had to play that. Are you still there?
Yes.
Okay, sorry. Jennifer, do you know all the details?
Yeah, I think you probably do.
Right now, they're very simple, and that is Madsen's. You've got to be there between 4:30 and 6:30, okay, to check in, and that's it. On the 23rd, between 4:30 and 6:30, come check in, and then hopefully you win the trip.
I'm winning it. This is mine. We're putting this.
I love it. Yeah.
That's good so luck good. To you, Jennifer. Have yeah. a nice weekend. Thank you so much. We'll
Bye.
See you later.
Have a good weekend.
You too.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Don? Why, yada. 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 To the moon with you. Oh, sweaty girl. Sweaty girl.
Donna,
Ronnie, I don't have time for you to be a flake. You tell me yes or no right now. Message me.
What'd he say?
He said something about his mom. I don't know.
His mom?
Well, no. He says, Mama said he always got a face for radio. Oh, he said, I just might. Let me think on it. No thinking.
No thinking.
No thinking. Just do it. Take a leap, man. I'm looking through your pics right now. We got a couple we can post. Let's go.
Yeah, and Johanna's very critical of those. Not of yours, but of just.
I need boys to take better pictures of themselves.
What's up, Nick?
What's up,
Nick? I wasn't saying it. I was just back here moving around.
Oh, I got you.
Just moving around.
He moves a lot when he sits.
Does he?
I think so.
I do.
You know what? Now you understand. I wish I could have pointed this out because it drives you crazy when I look at him when you're in California. You're like, what are you looking at? And it's because I'm looking at Nick. And you do it all the time now that you're sitting there.
You don't need to point out my faults.
It's not a fault. It's just, I'm telling you, it's a natural thing because we look at his face through the window.
Yeah, but I look and I come back down to you.
And I like looking at him when he starts laughing at stuff.
Do you?
Yeah. I know, I'm so bad at pictures. No, you got a couple really good ones for sure. I'm saying boys in general, not you. I guess in general you are a boy. I guess. Oh, my gosh. I have a boyfriend on the text group.
Who is it?
I don't know.
What's he want?
I don't know. Just
ding dong, nice. Long dong.
Long ding dong. That's the one you've been doing lately.
Yeah, long neck bottles.
Long ding dongers. In general, I'm a man. Ronnie, I know I'm an idiot.
What did he say now?
It was just the same thing I said. I was stupid. I said.
I know, I heard you.
Okay. You want to throw?
No, I don't want to throw down. Nick's going to come down and do jiu-jitsu with me before I leave, guys.
So we've heard. Don't get this man hooked yet.
He'll be fine.
You're going to pay for his membership?
I'll roll with him, though.
every time
you get free membership for a week.
Oh, and then you get hooked. That's how they get you.
Yeah.
That's how they get you.
Yeah, it's Pelican. That's not how you spell it, Dom. But yeah, it's Pelican.
Is it flirting if I send back this person a heart?
No.
They said, my God, Johanna's beautiful. That was very nice.
Yeah, I don't know if you do hard. Yeah. I don't think you do. I don't think that's flirting. That just makes you look like you're into yourself.
Oh, that's true. That's true. Sorry. Why can't I do the emojis on this guy? I just want to send him back an emoji, like a blushing one, maybe? That seems a little flirty as well.
I think I do laugh till you cry face.
Okay, laugh till you cry face.
Or shy. Do they have one like you're blushing?
That's blushing. I just said blushing and you said no.
I don't think so.
Should I say K?
I think I do. Ha ha ha. People don't do ha 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 anymore, do they?
He said.
Or LOL. Nobody does LOL. I do LOL.
We have. There's old ones. He said, good Lord, can I steal Johanna? I said, depends on your bank statements.
That's what you said. What if he's rich?
Well, we didn't send him.
Well, he's not going to send you
if
bank statements.
If he's rich, he's just going to have to understand that I have to still be with Dane. But
why?
Maybe. Because Dane is my love. So then here's what he's going to have to do. We have to talk to Dane. I wonder if Dane would be willing to pimp me out for money. Do you think so?
No.
No. Probably not.
No.
Probably not. Depends on the time that, like financially where we're at. You know what I mean? I think there are times when we're struggling when I think he would pimp me out.
If you guys decided.
Not like real pimp me out. Not like for real.
I know. We're just make believe here. But if you guys decided you're in a money pinch, you need money bad, in a bad way.
Okay.
And you both can go for equal dollar on the black market for a night.
Oh, no.
For one night.
No. No.
Who would you decide would do it?
Yes. Like
for the same amount of money.
Who would you decide would do it? I think we would both agree him.
Really?
I think so.
Because it'd be over with fast?
Is that sexist of me? But I feel like it's not as like.
But you'd be fine with that?
I wouldn't. No, I wouldn't be fine with it. But
and
I
and the person that you were on the black market with, were they were hot, both sides.
Yeah,
the guy was hot, girl was hot. And you'd be fine with letting him go.
I wouldn't be fine with it. You're telling me I don't have a choice. You're telling me I don't have a choice.
Yeah, I do.
You're saying I get a hall pass.
It's basically a hall pass. You get to have.
Is it Adam Sandler?
Sure.
It's 100% Adam Sandler. He has,
and it's also the girl that he has a hots for.
He doesn't have the hots for any girl ever, except for me. my hall pass is Adam Sandler. He has to have the equivalent of that.
No.
Yes.
Women find guys and girl, they find they're
you're
attracted
telling
different.
Me he's thinking like Megan Fox or some super hottie.
Yeah.
No, I don't like this game.
What's the female equivalent of Adam Sandler?
Well. It's
guys
not
aren't
the,
that way.
It's not. That's right. It's not the equivalent of Adam Sandler. It's the equivalent to the way Johanna feels about Adam Sandler.
Yeah, but you'll never have that as a man because you just think about.
No, you're attracted to him. You're attracted to him.
I'm attracted
sexually.
To-
You are.
I just don't like how you said that.
I know,
but
I'm
no,
just trying
I'm
to make
I'm
it clear.
I'm attracted to him like a celebrity, like
sexually
you-
celebrity.
No,
but I'm just
you're
saying
making
that
it
that's
into
the,
like a thing.
So he
and
has
it's like-
to be the same way with the woman.
Yeah, like an Amy Schumer.
No, then you'd be like, yeah, go do it all day long. Do it twice if
no,
you want.
No, I wouldn't, because what if she's way funnier? What if she's way
Selma
funnier
Hayek
than me?
All day. Selma Hayek is beautiful.
She is really beautiful.
Amy Schumer.
Indecent proposal. No, this is the thing. This doesn't work on me for real, because if you really, 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 really know who I am, I would live on dirt floors. I really don't care. I just genuinely don't care about that stuff. I like to be happy.
You say that, but every time I talk to you, you're remodeling a different part of your house.
I know, because I want it to look the way I like it to look. But it's not. You say remodeling. I do like.
DIYs,
and also it's very like financially like not crazy. Like it's not like we're tearing down walls or we are gonna have to do that to the bathrooms. But we're personalizing our little home.
She's my hall pass, Caitlin Zay. Who?
Selma Hayek.
Yeah, Selma Hayek is something else.
Yeah, she's, oh, jeez, God, I'm going to look at a picture of her. Lord.
And she's just a woman that it just seems like has not aged. But.
Yeah, she's really pretty.
Dun, 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 dun.
I don't think that's my flavor of woman, though.
Yeah.
Like, I think she looks like she'd yell at me for not cleaning.
She would.
Something.
She's spicy.
I don't want to be yelled at.
It's not fun.
Vampire!
Uh-oh.
Paul Rudd. Oh, that's a great one,
we
Caitlin.
We just missed the break.
Oh, good going. Paul Rudd's a really good hall pass. I have like 13 of them. Keep telling them. You're good at this. Does your husband know? Are you married? That you have so many hall passes? I really only have one, kind of. Oh, but then I don't know.
Yeah.
Long ding dongs. God, that stuck in my head.
Sorry.
Ronnie, what are you thinking about? Why am I so single, big guy?
We got to get a book, bud.
Sorry I called you that. That's what I call my little son. And then I feel weird when I say it to other people.
Bon Jovi, Leverchick?
Bon Jovi? Maybe. I like the rock and roll era, kind of, you know? That's cool.
I was watching Bruce Springsteen. Some video footage of him at a concert, and he was like dancing and singing with a fan. And for the first time, he looked to me like an old man. Like the way he was moving and stuff, you know, like.
Right. That's sad.
Yeah.
That's sad.
What is that?
My Ryan Reynolds and Ryan Gosling are my Ryan Gosling.
They're kind of the same flavor.
I love both of those ones too, actually. There's something about Ryan Gosling's humor though that I am severely attracted to. I think it's because it's very, very subtle. It's very subtle.
And Ryan is in your face a little bit.
He's a little extra goofy. But I still, him and Blake Lively are like just the cutest, most beautiful little couple. Mm-hmm. I think they're so adorable. And they always make fun of each other. I just love it. They do like the funniest jokes on each other, and it's just so fun to watch.
Mm-hmm.
Like he posts like awful pictures of her on her birthday and stuff.
Would you be okay if they had a Dane did that?
Yeah, I would think it depends. It's still like tasteful. I don't know how to explain it. He does it really well.
He finds the best of the worst.
It's just funny. I don't know. Oh, Gary loves J-Lo, and he needs to watch that stupid movie. Oh, my gosh. Anybody watch that stupid thing J-Lo made? Oh, my word. Whatever, love yourself if you want to love yourself, but she really extra loves herself. That thing she made, it was like a weird, it wasn't as crazy as people made it out to be, but some of the clips were. And I heard that as she's writing this new album, The Greatest Love Story Never Told. See, Ashley, you think like me. See, I'm really into funny guys. Obviously, it's good when they're attractive and funny, but I need someone to make me laugh. Anyway, this J-Lo thing. So it's called The Greatest Love Story Never Told, I think is her album. And I think it has to do with her and Ben Affleck, which is cute. So when Ben and her got back together, so now mind you, Ben has already been with J-Lo, got out of the relationship with J-Lo, married Jennifer Garner, was with her for years, then gets back with J-Lo and gives J-Lo like a book he made of all the letters that they exchanged, like a bunch of like personal stuff that him and J-Lo exchanged. He saved that through his marriage with Jennifer Garner. I would be so mad if I was Jennifer Garner. Anyway. So he gives that to her, and he finds out later as she's writing this album with all these writers, she brought that as inspiration and just let them all just like read through it. And Ben Affleck just seems like a really, like, what's it called? Like kind of a reserved guy. Like he doesn't like to be in the spotlight. I would be so mad. Oh, Sarah, it was terrible. I watched it for the fun of it. Look, here he is.
Hello, I'm Gary Greenwood. Yep, just doing the radio show here. Gary
Wow,
Greenwood.
Very impressive.
Yeah, you know, I'm just Gary Greenwood out here, you know, this weekend going to be Gary Greenwood, isn't it? And, you know, it's a Friday, so got to do the Gary Greenwood Friday, you know. Ooh, yeah, oh, got a sore right here, yep. Mm-hmm. How you doing, Johanna? Yeah, oh, you doing fine? That's good. I'm Gary Greenwood, yeah.
I used to be on a show like that.
No, I just Gary Greenwood here. Just Gary Greenwood, isn't it? Here on Friday, you know, and you know, just doing my radio thing, just doing it. You know, Friday we got What's in the Box, and you know that's coming up. Mm-hmm. Yeah, good time.
We already did it.
Mm-hmm.
Your namesake Corey Lang said, "And I'm out."
That's good. We gotta find the real listeners here.
Might as well ask Corey, who's your hall pass?
What for? What that?
Who's your hall pass? Like a celebrity you want to get with?
guy, or I can sleep with a guy. I can sleep with.
It's America 2024. Of course you can. Oh, jeez. That was predictable.
I don't know who my hall pass is.
There's no girl that you think is super hot, like a celebrity or a singer. I think that yours would be like super unconventional.
Well,
like Sierra Farrell.
Yeah, that'd be all right. She's got a lot of tattoos, though. She kind of little.
No, you're not, and you're into pure skin. I didn't realize that about you.
Yeah, pure. You know.
Okay. I didn't realize that about you.
I will say, though, the ex-wife, we've been at places where there was, like, attractive musicians, and they would, like, talk to me or whatever, and she says, you do realize that if you have a chance to get with that, you have to.
She gave you a pass?
Yeah. And she says, just as long as you send me some money.
She's so cool. That's so cool of her. I think that's, like, confidence. Or is it a trap? Because that sounds like something I would say. I'd be like, yeah, go ahead. Oh, and then he does it, and then I go, get out of my house.
It's true. Yeah, it's deep. Good thing I didn't fall for it.
Ashley said his whole pass was probably Betty White, but it's too late now.
Why is Ashley gotta
do like
that?
Them old. We know that.
It's kind of nice having
this Kathy Bates?
Going on with these comments.
Kathy Bates, though, supreme acting. She's a great actress.
See?
Have you seen Misery?
So good. I used to check that out from the library, and I'm pretty sure I was too young. I loved it. That's a Stephen King book.
Yeah. Ooh, looks like we got ourselves a Rita.
Yeah, you know what? I actually went and met Stephen King with this guy I was on a date with. It was actually kind of a cool date.
You met him?
He wasn't that weird, but it wasn't like a one-on-one thing. It was like he did a thing in Omaha. Like he was at a book. I think he was like out of Barnes & Noble. It was like just.
How much time do we have for the next break? Because you may have put some songs in.
You got about 4.5 minutes.
Is that going to get us to what time?
It's going to get us to 8:40.
It will?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Because we missed a break.
What's giggly, Caitlin?
Yeah, 8:39.
She's really good in the what's the scary show? What's the scary
American
show?
Horror Story.
You know what I'm talking about?
American Horror Story.
American Horror Story. She's really good in those seasons. The latest season of American Horror Story. Anybody watching that? It's terrible.
That's all weird.
Did you watch any of them?
I tried watching it when it first came
out. Did you get too scared?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was freaking out.
I feel like you wouldn't like scary stuff.
No, I'm not a big fan of that at all.
I
don't like scary stuff.
Yeah,
no.
I knew it. I could get that vibe from you.
I just, especially in the theater.
I love it.
Goal. What? It's this guy. Well, he's a loser.
Yeah, he's a loser. L7 Weenie.
What do I do? Pot him up. Mic 4. Yeah, buddy.
Can I run the board better than Corey?
You speaking? No. Oh, there he is. He's on M2.
I'm watching it now. Disturbing. Which one? Are you watching the new season, Linda? Because I don't think it's that great. I'm like, okay, we get it. They're witches and they're trying to make a demon baby. Okay.
It's been a long time since I've been in here. You talked. Speak.
American Horror Story is one of my favorite shows.
Can you figure it out?
Yeah, I got it.
Do you need some help?
No, I'm good. I'm good.
No, let me help him. That'll really.
Yeah, it'll really learn me a lesson.
I'm just glad the cam can see this so that they know audio is difficult. I'm not the only one that struggles with it.
Are you talking to me? Sorry. My headphones are really quiet. What?
I said I'm glad the cam can see this right now so they know that I'm not the only one that struggles with audio.
Who's struggling? Oh, he's struggling? That's good.
It's a poor thing.
He takes his headphones off.
He got mad.
See ya. You're done, Nick. Good knowing you, buddy. We talked about
Nick gets a brunt of stuff sometimes. Okay, he can make some jokes.
You guys talked about OJ dying.
Oh, please enlighten us. You're reading the paper. I get it.
Yeah, OJ died.
Do you like liquid death? Have you tried it? It's canned water. I don't know how I feel about
that's
that.
Good. It's good.
It's better. Is drinking out of a canned water better than drinking the microplastic? So probably.
Yeah. Right. You got 2 minutes.
You're supposed to just let him do the break. I thought he was just going to do the break. Oh.
What break is it?
40.
Oh, are we going to that?
Oh, yeah. You should talk about it. Oh, you don't have a microphone. Get a microphone.
No, you guys just do it. I'll take a break.
I will walk out right now.
What? Wow.
I just hurt his feelings.
I'm just kidding, Corey.
Get over here. You got a minute 30.
All right.
Come on, big boy. No. Do the break on my lap. No. Do the break on my lap.
Two big men in one spot is too much.
Corey, are you going to go?
Yeah.
You really are. Are you lying to me?
I'm going.
Are you actually going to show up? Because yesterday you kept telling me that you weren't going.
Well, I have a busy, busy weekday that day, though.
What are you doing in the morning? You have a remote? Husker
when?
Practice?
When?
Tomorrow, 9:30.
That's tomorrow.
I got two
tomorrow?
Why are you going to all the practices?
You got invited personally.
From Mr. Rule himself? It's in Texas.
Down. We'll see you, Ashley. Take care. Have a nice weekend.
Bye. All the Golden Girls.
All the Golden Girls. That's about right. Because you had SEX with that one girl who's dead now.
What did you? We don't know. She could be in her 80s.
Yeah, she could be in her 80s.
You can live. My grandma lived to be 103.
I know, but it's fun.
It's fun that she's dead.
Yeah. It's better. It's better for the story if she aged out. You know what I mean?
I just love the honesty. It cracks me up. It's better that she's dead. Okay.
We don't know her.
That doesn't
and
mean
we all die. We all die.
We all die. You're right. Embrace death.
We all die.
Oh, yuck. Wild
horses. Hey, Camp Fam. Watch live now. Facebook.com/Froggy981.
There's a barbecue contest tomorrow. And Johanna is one of the judges. She has no idea what she's doing.
Yeah. I've been watching a few cooking shows to see if I can get some knowledge before I am about to embark on this endeavor. But I'm kind of excited. I'm nervous and excited.
For ribs, right? You're judging ribs.
I'm judging ribs. Yes.
At the Kincator tomorrow. Down in the Haymarket.
Yeah.
2:00 is when you can show up. And you can help us raise some money. So that's why it's a fundraiser for a... What do you have to do to get a Purple Heart? Do you even know what that is?
I think you have to get hurt.
Because your heart...
I think a Purple Heart is if you get hurt in combat.
No.
It's more than
that?
That
doesn't sound
you
right.
Have to get hurt,
you know how many people have gotten hurt in combat? They don't get Purple Heart. I think that's for bravery.
Hurt and save someone.
I think Purple Heart means bravery
You're
all
right.
day long.
I don't know. Maybe it does. A lot of people get hurt in combat.
So they're doing this barbecue tomorrow, and the proceeds go to trying to get a motorcycle for somebody who got a Purple Heart. Purple Heart is the United States military decoration? No, not
It's who suffered a wound as a direct or indirect result of enemy action the wound required treatment by a medical officer at the time of the injury. So I'm right. Wounded or killed as a result of enemy action while serving in the U.S.
I know, but it says the heart-shaped badge is purple because the color represents courage and bravery.
Well, yeah. So, I mean, obviously, if you get hurt in combat, and you're pretty brave.
It's the oldest military award. Huh. Well, there's somebody who got one of those. And we're trying to help them out. So you come down to the Kincator tomorrow, and you grab yourself you get a plate. You get three ribs, pulled pork sandwich, some chips, some water, I think.
Yeah.
$20, and that money goes to help this fundraiser they've got going on. Johanna will be out there. Corey, who thinks he's going to get free food, is going to be out there as well. And he actually may be one of the judges.
Yeah, I don't really know what's going on there. He was acting like he was going to judge. So I don't know if he's making that up or if he was actually asked.
Yeah, I think maybe he's a backup.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, somebody doesn't show. So, I don't know. Do you know what you're doing? Like, do you have any idea the criteria that is based as appearance, tenderness, and taste, I think? Those are the three levels of
criteria. Appearance, tenderness, and taste. Yes. Yeah. That's what I'm judging it on. But I don't really know, I don't really know how serious they are. Like, if there's, numbers I have to give or words.
What if they hand you a microphone to describe this rib?
Oh, gosh.
Gonna be a struggle, ain't it?
No, it's not. I'll just say juicy or something. I mean, I can come up with some rib adjectives, I'm sure.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think I'm gonna do. I like the idea I came up with the other day. Thumbs up, thumbs down.
That's what I like.
Bring
too.
In the show. Bring in the show into it.
That's what I like too.
And you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna do like Caesar, back in the Roman days when they had gladiators, and I'm gonna put my thumb out sideways.
Yeah.
And then make them all wait.
That's
and
right.
Then, like,
that's right. That's what they did in the movie Gladiator, right?
Yes.
With Russell Crowe. I love that part. Yeah. That's
thumbs
what you need
down.
To do. Right.
Dead. Your ribs are so bad, you're dying.
Kill them right
Kill
now.
Em.
Who made these ribs? Kill them.
Yeah.
It's at the Kinkator tomorrow. It'll get started at 2 o'clock, goes till 8 o'clock. They got live music, like three live bands
three?
Are going to be
yeah.
on there.
Yeah.
And it's our good buddy, Anthony. We call him Breadman on the show, who's helped us out a ton. He's one of them that's spearheading this. So we thought he helps us in the show. We got to go down and support him and help him as well.
Yeah.
And then we found out how great of a cause it is, and we're all in.
Absolutely.
Obviously, anyway. So that'll be tomorrow starting at 2 o'clock down at the Kinkator.
Gary and Johanna. For sure. Morning 6 to 10.
Good morning.
Only thing I can do is keep it up.
Live on Facebook, YouTube, and on the Nebraska Now app. Froggy.
Texas Hold'em. You go down, 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 down.
Damn. Moist and tangy, Caitlin. Those are great words. Thank
Moist,
you.
Moist, tangy.
Maybe we should put
smoky.
Oh, it's a little too late. Smoky, that's good. Should I start trying to guess the ingredients?
Tough,
or is that dangerous?
Gristly.
Gristly, that's bad.
I know. You got to have bad ones, though, too.
What this if there, it's not? None of them are bad.
Ball off the bone.
For appearance, should I like do selfies with each of the ribs and decide which one looks the best?
For selfies, do
like take pictures for appearance.
That's
the
a good idea. What are you gonna wear? White t-shirt? Do you have barbecue sauce all over
great
it?
Great idea. I'm gonna wear a big bib.
Yeah.
Like a huge bib.
Yeah.
It's a great idea.
Thank you. Do my best. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you're good at that.
This ain't Texas.
Fork tender. What does that mean?
Fork
what does that
tender?
Mean?
I don't know what that
Look
means.
Look at the smoke ring. I don't know what that means, guys. Do I just say it? Or do I have to actually see a smoke ring? Can I just say that this one's got a nice smoke ring?
Oh, smoke ring. Yeah, it's good. Smoke ring's good.
Oh, Gary Greenwood is watching.
Is that what it said?
Yeah. It ain't Texas. The bark. The bark.
Yeah, the
oh,
bark.
The bark. I've heard my
husband
say this before.
Stuff. Oh, the bark. That's hard to get.
The bark. It's got good bark. But is it bark like for a tree or bark like a dog?
Bark like tree, not like a dog.
Like, you know, this meat's singing?
Yeah.
This meat is barking. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So is it the dog or the tree?
It's the tree.
But do you see what I mean? Are you sure you're right?
No.
Like my dogs are barking.
My dog's barking and my feet gotta breathe.
But I'm saying, can the meat bark?
No, you keep going on to bark.
Cause they said bark!
Because it's the tree.
Oh my God, but you just agreed with me about the dogs barking.
No, I was explaining to you, gotta let my dogs bark. Ain't that my gotta kick my shoes off? My feet bark or something?
Yeah,
what
but
is
to
it?
Me, it's something is emitting from it if it's barking. So
it's
like
not
the
a smell.
Bark.
It's the bark is the tree where it emulates the crust on the outside
so
of the tree.
Crust bark.
I'm not playing along with this.
Whatever. It's not supposed to fall off the bone. It's not?
Yes, it is.
Bone should be clean. You guys, this is conflicting. This
conflicting?
Is conflicting. Conflict. It's very controversial, but yeah, I don't know if it conflicts.
conflicting.
And yes, Gary is right. It's the bark. You guys aren't saying nothing.
We're saying the same thing, all of us.
No. Like this slaps, this barks.
Yeah.
He agrees.
I'm not listening to you. I don't know what you said.
You agreed.
I don't even know
don't
what you said.
Don't agree if you don't listen. listen, if I say kill me now, and you just go, yeah.
Then you know that I'm not listening.
No, what if I was seriously asking?
Why would I kill you?
What if I'm saying, am I worthless? Yeah.
I didn't listen. I didn't listen at all.
I'm leaving. You know, this is what you said to me. You know you're the only person in here that I talk to. You're the only person in this room.
What are you talking about?
Oh, my God. You weren't listening yet again?
When did I say that? I don't remember.
You just did, like a week ago.
This ain't Texas. You not hold them. Go down, down, down.
You talk to yourself now. I'm done talking.
What do you mean? I got to get stuff ready here. Did you ever hear back from Ronnie?
Joe.
You ever get back from Ronnie?
Yeah. I'm sorry, what'd you say?
You do this all the time.
I'm sorry, what'd you say?
You know how often I talk to you and you don't respond either?
Yes, I do. I always do.
I'm tired, guys.
No, I didn't hear back. You know who else? Oh, there we go. Someone. Nick, are you reading messages again and not unreading them?
No.
What?
No.
No?
I haven't looked at any
Someone
messages.
Someone read this? Huh?
I've hardly been on Facebook today.
Anybody else surprised that guy today was purely Facebook? He was a little bit older, maybe.
I don't know how I didn't see this message from him then.
What'd he say?
No, I'm talking about our couple from yesterday.
Oh, no. What'd they say?
No, nothing.
But he didn't say nothing.
I just didn't. He wasn't getting back to me with his number and stuff, and then I... Oh.
St. Texas, you got hold 'em. Yes. That's where I got it from.
You done talking, tough guy? What are you talking about?
Step Brothers, from my chest pubes to my ball fro.
Wow, they seem like medical professionals. I would definitely think that they would know.
Suppose Nancy sees me coming out of the shower and decides to come on me. I'm looking good.
I've
got a luscious V of hair going from my chest pubes down to my ball fro.
That's one of my all-time favorite movies.
That's a great movie. I saw it in the movie theater and
I think you can also call them pubes because they're curly. It's the contour of the hair.
So you're telling me if you have curly hair on your head, they're pubes.
I think they would get called
curly
pube
arm
hair.
Hairs. Pubes.
Pube head. I think people would call them. I think they would get. I think that that's one thing that they would get
oh
called.
My God.
Not fair. They shouldn't be.
Make it a thing.
/Froggy981. Hope you have a great weekend. Thank you for catching the show this morning and every morning. That truly means a lot to us. Congratulations to our finalists for Garth Brooks. All weekend long, we'll have more keywords. So make sure to be listening to the radio, okay? When you hear a keyword, text it in. Go to froggy981.com and enter it in online too. And then maybe Monday we'll be calling you, giving you the good news. You could be going to see Garth in Las Vegas over 4th of July weekend. Airfare, hotel, transportation, all included in that. His residency in Vegas. I think that's it for us. Have a great day today. Enjoy the beautiful weather, mid 80s all weekend long. So whatever you got going on, enjoy yourself. We'll see you back here on Monday. And hopefully at some point this weekend, if you're single, we'll have a Why Am I Still Single feature posted. We're working on the guy that was on the show this morning.
Yeah.
He was a winner. Ronnie. I didn't know. He was trying to get the girl that was in here.
She was cute. Kayla. Yeah, he was trying to get Kayla on, but we had already asked Kayla if she was single, and she said no.
Yeah, she's taken already. Yeah, so he's trying to get scraps here at the radio station, but she already taken. And so he would think, naturally, he would want to come on, why am I still single? But now he's got to think about it.
He needs to come on if he's looking. He's clearly looking for someone to go on this trip with him.
Yeah. Yeah.
So
either it'll be him or somebody else. We'll be highlighting somebody this weekend, but we'll see you back here on Monday. Hopefully, we'll see you tomorrow at the Kinkator. If not, have a wonderful weekend. Enjoy the there's so much stuff going on this weekend. The PPR is in town this weekend at Pinnacle Bank Arena, so hopefully you're checking that out as well. A bunch of music coming your way with some Morgan Wallen. He will be on your radio next.
First thing in the morning.
Early in the morning, waking that sun.
All right, guys. We'll see you later. Have a nice weekend. Bye. Johanna, say bye.
Thank you guys for listening to Gary and Johanna. And have a wonderful day.